You are welcome, brethren, unto the presence of God the Most High. You might have come by your understanding, but I want to tell you it is not you that came that made yourself to come. It is God that enabled you, for it is Him that gives you the capacity both to will, to do, and to accomplish His work. And this morning we want to share the topic. The call to soul winning in His vineyard. The call to soul winning in His vineyard. Bible speaking in the book of John chapter 15. And we shall take it from verse 1 to 16. And Jesus said, I am the true vine. My Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth no fruit, He taketh away. Every branch in me that beareth fruit, He purgeth it, that they may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. 5. I am the vine, and ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. So, here we emphasize on the verses of the Bible, that John chapter 5, verse 16, which says, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, and have ordained you, that ye should go forth and bear fruit, that your fruit may abide. And therefore, ask anything of the Father in my name, that He may give it to you. The call to serve in the vineyard of God, the call to soul winning in the vineyard of God, is very important, even especially in these last days, where the devil is making vigorous campaign. The devil is making vigorous campaign to be able to win many, as many so as possible, to hell. But we, the children of God, we on the other side, we are to be able to make it that we should serve in the vineyard for soul winning. Know this, every soul winner, they are called of God. Except you have personal relationship with God, except God is your Father and His Spirit liveth inside you, you may not be qualified to walk in this vineyard or to be enlisted to do this work of God. That is why many people, they are still saying, well, I know I love God, and maybe tomorrow I will take my decision. But the Bible speaking in the book of John chapter 4 and verse 35, and say ye not, there are yet 4 months, and therefore come at the harvest. I say unto you, lift up your eyes to the harvest here, and look for the white already for harvest. Verse 36 of it says, for he that reapeth receiveth wages, and gathereth unto life eternal, that both him that sweat and he that reapeth may rejoice together. Both him that sweat and he that reapeth may rejoice together. So we find here that the corner has a particular attribute. It has a particular attribute, as you can see from the book of Matthew, chapter 10, and verses 1 to 8. The corner has a peculiar attitude in the soul winning mission. And one of these is the calling of Father Abraham, the calling of Father Abraham in the book of Genesis chapter 12 and verse 1 to 3, we say that he said unto Abraham, come thee out of thy country, come thee out of thy kindred, come thee out of thy people, and go to the land which I will show you. The land which I will show you. Shall we go to the book of Genesis? Genesis chapter 12. And he said, verse 2, I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. So he said unto them, I will make thee a great nation. I will make thee a great nation. Therefore, it means when the caller is calling you, he has an agenda to be able to make thee great. He has an agenda for you to make you a blessing. That is why he said in that verse 2, say, I will make thee a great nation. I will bless thee, and I will make thy name great. Everyone that have obeyed or have yielded for this call to serve, this call for soul winning, everyone that yielded for the call to soul winning in the vineyard of God is ever in favor or in love with God. Because there is this attribute. He called them all from the book of Genesis, even to the New Testament. God is still calling people, and up to this our generation, he is still calling people, saying, the harvest is plentiful. We have so much work in this vineyard, so much work is loaded. Will you give your time unto God for him to use it? Will you give your boat unto God as Apostle Peter gave his boat to God for use? Will you give your talent unto God for him to use? Will you give him the money that God has given you? Will you lay it down for him to use? All this thing, it comes a great day if you can confess with your mouth that you are a child of the kingdom, that you are heaven bound. If you are heaven bound, therefore, you must be a soul winner, because you were saved by grace, and through soul winning exercise was the process through which you yourself were saved. It is either you got saved as someone invited you to church. That might be the process you got saved. It might be that you got saved as a result of the flyer you saw on the ground, and you took up the flyer and you began to read it, and faith came into you. The Bible says, consequently, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. It might be that you got saved as a result of a broadcast on the television. It is money that made this broadcast to happen. Some people are paid through it so that every other people can be able to benefit. It might be that you got saved, or you become a believer as a result of one engagement or the other through soul winning. Some, they are in the labor room of prayer on their knees asking God, say, oh Lord, arrest the soul of this person. Let this person be useful to you. Let this person, let him yield unto you. All these exercises are exercise of soul winning in the vineyard, and every one of them is having a great promise, saying, I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and I will make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. All these are those that are accompanying with everyone that make themselves ready to be able to serve in this vineyard. One, another example of this was the call of Moses. When he called Moses, he introduced himself unto Moses, saying, I am that I am. He is telling Moses, I am that I am. I am all in all. I am the God Almighty. I am that I am, as we can find it in the book of Exodus chapter 4 verse 4. But in Exodus chapter 4 verse 14, God made it clear, go and say unto them that I am sent you. That I am sent you. When he called Joshua, in the book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 2, he introduced himself as Elohim. That is the ever-present and powerful God. So all these attributes of this caller, they make the mission of the soul winner to be so easy, to be able to identify the one that called you. So when the soul winner is in the exercise of this soul winning, and there are waves, and there are turbulence, and when the wind, the rain fall, and when the wind blow, and the house falleth not, because it is established upon the rock. Upon the rock, because the foundation is the color. When you are able to identify that the color that called you is Elohim, therefore, you are not more afraid of any King Herod. You are not more afraid of any Jezebel on your part anymore. You are not more afraid of any persecution of whatsoever. You stand there because Elohim is the one that has sent you on this errand of soul winning in his vineyard. He is the one that sent you on this errand. When he called Samuel, Samuel was a little boy, and he called him that he should judge the children of Israel, as we can see in 1 Samuel chapter 3 and verse 11 to 13. And as a little boy, Samuel, he heard the voice of God. He heard the voice of God, and he awoke, and he looked around, who is calling me? And God led him to know the thought that I am your God that is calling you. Every call of God should be taken with great joy. Every call of God should be taken with great zeal. That is why the psalmist said, the zeal of the Lord has consumed me. The reproach of them that reproached thee has fallen upon me. So the zeal of and hunger to work for in this soul winning exercise should be a thing that should fill us in the inside and in the outside, because there's no more time. That is why he said unto them, say, go and speak unto the hidden, for the kingdom of God is at hand. For the time and the day, no man knoweth when the master cometh. The time and the day, no one knoweth. So everyone should get prepared. And God is looking for the vessel that he wants to use. He's still searching. Saying, for God does not look as into the face as man do at the face. For God look at the heart, saying, I have found David my servant. As he was searching, he sat and saw the heart of David. That David was a soul winner. He was dead and very, very, very strong in rescuing the people of God from dominion of darkness. That is, in other words, bringing them from kingdom of darkness to kingdom of light. Everyone that has chosen to stand out of the crowd and to be able to spearhead, or to be able to be in the forefront of this revival, the Lord is going to decorate that person. The Lord is going to change the story of that person. Number four of these attributes was when he called David in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16 and verse 13, he introduced himself as the shepherd. He is the shepherd. That is, David as a shepherd boy, he was tending the sheep of his father and taking care of the sheep. And when the lion wanted to come and steal or kill any of the sheep, and David would go after the lion, and David would smote the lion and slay him. And when the bear wanted to come, and he would stop the bear and smote and kill him. Therefore, he has this great passion. He has this great passion to be able to rescue the people of God from the clutches of the Philistine, from the clutches and the hands of Goliath. No wonder. He got the head of Goliath in his hand. Therefore, we see that the Lord Jesus Christ made himself more clearer to us as he called us into service in the New Testament. The call that we see Jesus in the book of Matthew chapter 10 and verse 1, he revealed himself unto us. Also in the book of John chapter 6 verse 35. John chapter 6 verse 35 says, he is the bread of life. He is the bread of life. John chapter 6 and verse 35. And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall never hunger. He that believeth on me shall never thirst. So, he is telling everyone that he calls for soul winning in his prayer. Believe on me, you will never be hungry anymore. Believe on me, for you will never thirst anymore. You will never thirst anymore. So, Jesus also introduced himself in the New Testament to us in the book of John chapter 4 verse 14 to that woman at the well. And the woman at the well, the woman of Samaria, will always come to draw water from the well. Jesus had said to this woman, woman, give me water that I may drink. And the woman of Samaria answered, it is not lawful for me, the Samaritan woman, to give water to you, the Jewish man, to drink. In the end, Jesus said to the woman, where is your husband? Where is your husband? And the woman said, I have no husband. Jesus said, yes, truly, you don't have husband. You have had five husbands, even the one you are with now, you are not married to him. After all this said and done, the woman went straight to the city and went to go and tell everyone. John chapter 4 and verse 39. For in that book of John chapter 4 verse 39, and the woman opened her mouth and said, come and see, come and see, come and see, the man that told me all that I ever did. Is this not the Christ? Is this not the Christ? And many of the Samaritans of that city, they believe on him, Jesus, because of the testimony of that woman. Because of the testimony of that woman that he said, he told me all that I ever did. And they said to the woman, we believe not on Jesus because of your testimony alone, but we will have seen that this is Christ Jesus himself, because all we have used our eye to see, all we have heard with our ears, we are convinced that this is Christ. That this is Christ. Therefore, it's very simple. No one will say, I am disadvantaged, I don't have education, that is why I cannot be enlisted in a so many exercise. No one will say, because, you know, I don't have the finances, and that is why I am not able to be enlisted. And so many in his vineyard, no one will say, you know, I'm very busy. You know, I'm very busy. And you know that I know how to make money so much time. You know, I'm always occupied. Who told you you can also be a soul winner, even in your very present place of assignment or in your place of your career? You can be a soul winner. There are many channels that is open to you. That is open to you. Jesus called the woman, said, I am the living water. That is what he told the woman, that woman, John chapter 4, verse 13. He said, I am the living water. He that believeth on me, out of his belly shall flow, shall bring the springs of flowing of living water. Out of his belly shall spring forth the fountain of living water. So we find out in soul winning, it's the only avenue for you to market Jesus unto the world. It is only in soul winning and all the avenue that is surrounding it that you can be able to market Jesus unto the world. Many are ignorant of what they are doing because they have no teacher, they have no counselor to be able to tell them what they are doing is wrong. And will you just sit down there and say that all is well with you and you are praying and expecting God to change your story? Why? You are still better than many others that they are in the valley of indecision between hell and heaven. They are considering which one to take. But only your propagation of this gospel, only your testimony that you can share that this woman of Samaria, she did not quote by you. She only said, come and see. This man that told me all that ever did, is this not the Christ? And by so doing, many souls were saved in that city of Samaria. And the life of God enter into that city, and people put their faith in God because of the confession of this woman. What is there in your confession if you are a believer? What is there in your confession if you are a believer? The moment the woman of Samaria believed, she did not keep quiet. She went out to go and tell others. The moment that woman of Samaria has received Jesus Christ into her life, nothing again is standing before her as a barrier. Nothing is stopping her from going to tell someone else and bring them. This is the same way that it happens to Andrew, the disciple. One person or the other will bring another person. One person or the other will bring another person to Jesus. One person or the other will bring another person to Jesus. If you will not invite or bring another person to Jesus, then what is your own classification as a disciple? What kind of disciple or what class of disciple are you? If only it is about me, myself, and I. Only me, myself, and I in this kingdom. Jesus is asking everyone. He is making a call for soul winning in his vineyard. He is making a call for soul winning in his vineyard because there's no more time. Because there's no more time. And he does not desire that any man should perish. He does not desire that any man should perish, but that everyone should be able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Should be able to come to the knowledge of the truth, because Jesus himself, he is the truth. He is the light. He is the truth. He is the life. I read about the testimony of one old man that was sharing flyer, and the man was at the city junction and was sharing flyer, an old man, and there was a woman that was walking towards this man, and the woman was carrying in her hand like a child of like 10 years. And the woman, when he got in contact with this old man, and the woman shouted at this old man, "Old man, why are you disturbing people here about accept Jesus? Jesus is the way. Receive him today. Repent. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." And she pushed the man, even the man to the ground, and the man was sitting there looking at this woman. But afterwards, after a few minutes, this woman began to cry. This woman began to cry because the woman was carrying the little child, shouting, "Mommy, mommy, mommy, mommy." And the mother was so astonished as to what has come over the child that has not spoken in all these years. The child now is speaking for the first time. The child now is speaking, knowing fully that Jesus, that this old man he was marketing at that city gate, is able to perform signs and wonders in the life of anyone that is going about to do this job of soul winning. He is able to change the story, instant changing of story of the person at any time. You make the hands of God to be so short when you have not taken action. You are not taking a step to exercise your faith in this soul winning endeavor. When he said to you, "Go and bear fruit," and you refuse, say, "No, I don't have the time now, you know. And even what will people say? I am a socialite, and everybody knows me as a good man in this area. I'm very popular. And everybody knows me as a woman that is very industrious at what? And everybody are Christians already, so what is the need of being proclaiming about this gospel? Everybody knows I'm a good woman. I'm going about telling them to repent. After all, in all this area, we are all believers. This is not so. It is not for you to conclude that everyone has been saved, but it is a call for you that you should walk. You should walk the walk of your Father while it is called the day. A time is coming in the night where no man can walk. A time is coming in the night where no man can walk. You can say what Jesus said unto us to convince us to be much stronger in this world, so that we will not be weak. He said in the book of 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9, said, but ye are royal priesthood. Ye are royal priesthood. Ye are peculiar generation. Ye are holy people, that he has come out to show for the praise of him who has called us out of darkness into the kingdom of his marvelous light. So he saved us for the principal purpose that we should also be able to save others. God is not glorified when you are not bearing fruit. John chapter 15 made us to understand that he is the true vine, and his father is the husbandman. He cut every branch in him that does not bear fruit. Every branch in him that refuses to yield fruit is a waste of heaven resources. May the Lord make everyone under the sound of my voice all across the nations of the earth and everywhere to have this change of heart by the hands of the Holy Spirit upon your heart, and to make them to begin to walk and to be able to profit the kingdom of heaven. What benefit it is when you shall return back unto God and go with him with no any fruits, while many others that he gave the same time that he gave you, they came with a lot of harvest. They came with a lot of harvest in heaven. So the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, except that branch be connected to the vine, the branch cannot of itself bear any fruit. So there are many believers that were a part of the branch. They were branch of the vine in the beginning. But through discouragement, through the hustling and bustling of life, through so many challenges, and the seed of the word of God that was working in their heart have been stolen by the devil. This is why we need to be instant. We need to be instant at work. We need to be energized. We need to be motivated to be able to tell people about this gospel of the Lord Jesus, right? From time to time, from time to time. And therefore, when you are doing this, you are not doing it alone. The Holy Spirit, which is the Comforter, is there to be able to empower you so that all those words you are speaking, they will have meaning in the ears of the hearers. So that those words you are speaking, they are not yours. They are being passed by the person who is the caller. The caller is Jesus himself. The caller, he is backing you up to perform the counsel of his messenger. He is backing you up to be able to perform the counsel of his messenger. Because faithful is he that calleth you. Faithful is he that calleth you. Who also will do it? Who also will do it? So every caller in the clear balance is a soldier before the Lord. As a soldier, you don't complain there is rain. You don't complain there is hunger. You don't complain I don't have shoe. You don't complain I don't have this. You don't complain. You are ready, instant, motivated, energized to be able to set out to rescue as many souls as are possible while you are still standing alive. Apostle Paul, he nailed the urgency of this exercise when he said, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Is gain. For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Say, I will do the work of my Father. I will do the work of my Father. Soul winning is the best and greatest job ever that any woman should be able to desire to do. You have lost your job. Congratulations. This is the best time for you to win soul. You are already working in your office. This is another good opportunity for you to win soul. That is why every one of us that we recognize our Lord Jesus Christ and we recognize his position that he's occupying in our heart, that the position is the highest position in our heart. we shall not look back in this soul winning exercise. So shall it be. In Jesus' precious and mighty name, we have prayed.